Okay, so you just purchased Chiagra and you want to know how to use LaserCut. We will start the showcase from this model, so that's a really basic model. It's an editable polygon, and we will call Chiagra LaserCut. So we will go to Chiagra menu, LaserCut, show UI, LaserCut UI, check, and here we go. What I did myself is I created a Chiagra shortcut, so Chiagra show a Chiagra shortcut, and on the L key I added LaserCut. So you can do it like this, edit function. I did a right click on the L key and edit function. Then I go here and I can pick here Chiagra LaserCut, LaserCut UI. Hop, so I will close it and I can call LaserCut with my shortcut. So now we need to understand that here we can pick different Boolean type operation. So here we do have the subtract, the split, the union, the create. We will start from the create. I will tell to LaserCut, this is my model, this is my root model. I will call it root model, and I want to use it. So I will pick it like this, root. So now LaserCut know that each operation need to be applied to that mesh. You can do it with current and active selection, but I prefer using CNode. So if we are in create mode, we can create different type of primitives. So here I will create just a box. Here I will create just a cylinder. Here I will create a polyline. Yes. And polyline can be fillet. So if you need to remove one create operation, you can just delete it, basically, because they are standalone objects, okay? Now we will switch to union. Union is a union operation, so I will create a box like this. Hop. And I have my union operation. I can create a cylinder. So that is really basic, okay? That is a union. So now my model is more complex, and they are merged inside. So that's a simple Boolean operation. Now the split one. The split one doesn't exist in 3D Studio Max basic. So we created it. And if you do a split with box, like this, let's say like that, now you do have two different objects. Okay, this is the split one. And now the subtract, this is the one I use mostly because it's really handy. So I will just subtract a Kencon, for example. Hop. And the nice thing is that I can use wheel control. So if I stay over the selected Kencon, I can control and mouse scroll to increase or decrease the amount of segment. Okay. And they can be controlled as well for fillet, like this. Okay. So this is super handy. I will continue with polyline like this and click, 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 click. Yes. Hop. And if I right click, I go in edit mode and I can fillet, for example. All right. So we used auto grid cutters. So auto grid cutters are projected on the polygon, so on the plane under the mouse. So if I select a box and come here, it will be aligned nicely, okay? So this is the autogrid cutters. Autogrid cutters are projected on the plane. But we do have screen cutters too, okay? So screen cutters can be subtract from the screen space. So here I will create a rectangle and it will be projected from the screen. So it's like if my screen was a glass and I project a box from it. So hop, if I leave, I can then fill it. But look, if I now move my workspace, my viewport, we can see that the projection was done from the screen, so it is not parallel. That is totally normal. But if you want to use screen cutters, you can do it from orthographic view and it will work perfectly. So here I will do a circle. And voila. Screen cutters pass through the object, so entirely. While autogrid cutters, if I come back and do a cylinder in autogrid, I can have the control on the depth. So it don't pass through the object. It can be stopped. Okay? So once I'm happy, I can turn my object ineditable poly, sorry. So here we do have some cool stuff in utilities that can be really helpful. So if you want to remove this, don't delete it because it is a subtract cutter. You need to do it from here, utilities, remove selected cutters. Okay, and this will remove the cutter. If I want to remove this one, I can do it and remove selected cutter. Okay, so for now, I will add once again a subtract like this. Hop, hop, leave. And now we can add any modifier on that model, so on that scatters. So here I will do an edit poly. I will select I need to leave manipulate mode and I will select that edge and I can now chamfer it. So hop, I use wheel control to add segments and apply, and as you can see it didn't work. Why? Because we need to move it a bit, maybe. Oh, what's going on? Here it works. Okay. So now let's say that we want to modify the root object. We can do it from create root object instance and it duplicate the object. We can move that instance. And here now I can, so that is the root object before I added all the Boolean operation, and I can tweak it. So if I want to chamfer this one, I can. And as you can see, it is applied to the other object too. That is really helpful if you forgot to add something. So for example, here I subtract, hop, and voila. So one other cool thing is that if you do have an object, an object you're happy with, so like here I will do a box, I will move it, and I will modify it. So turn to editable poly. extrude. And now let's say I want to make this object become a cutter. So I select the object and I select here the mode, the Boolean operation I want to apply to that object. And here I say make cutter from selection. So here subtract mode is active, so it will become a subtract. So make cutter from selection. And now I do have my object here in wireframe. And if I move it, hop, 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 boom, it is now subtract. Okay? So that's it. Here we can change the color of the different type. So as you can see, each type do have its own color. So orange is split, yellow is subtract, green is additive, and blue is subtract. So that's it, really. You need to play with it and tell us what you think. Cheers, have a great day, bye.